Are you the type of person who likes to have everything gathered within the same tool? Then today's product showcase might be for you. Today's product showcase is Agiled, and it's an all-in-one business tool. When I first signed into Agiled, it reminded me a lot about Bitrix24, as many of you probably know. You can basically do everything related to your business within Agiled. You can send out invoices, you can manage projects, you can manage your employees, you can manage contracts, and so much more. It's very easy to get started with Agiled, so without further ado, let's dive into Agiled and test out their different modules. When you sign into Agiled, this is basically your dashboard, where you have all of the statistics of your clients, projects, teammates, hours logged, unpaid invoices, and so on. You have different graphs down here, based on how much you're earning, your task, how you're performing, what's pending, active projects, and so on. A cool small thing is you can add sticky notes down here if there's something you just want to remember and cannot forget. And then you will always have the sticky notes down here. I will say, however, the arrow here is a little bit difficult to hit because of the live chat right here. Now, over at the left side here, you can see all of the different modules that Agiled contains. Up here, we have if we want to start a timer, track our time for a specific project, task, or similar things. We have the active timers running. We have our notifications if we've been mentioned, if we have any changes we need to be aware of. We have a quick menu here where we can go to the team, projects, finance, CRM, contracts, or time tracking. We can change the language and back to the dashboard. Then we can, of course, configure the dashboard if there's stuff we want to add or remove if we don't find it relevant. It works seamlessly well, but let's dive into their newest module, which is a customer relationship module. It is very basic, but it has the functionality that you need. Here you will have an overview of your different customers. And for each customer, let's say an account could be a company. And for each company, you will have contacts underneath the company. They would lay in here, and you can migrate from an old CRM if you have used a CRM elsewhere. One thing to notice is the menu. Every time I go into a sub menu point, then it closes the menu. That's kind of annoying. That could be an easy thing for them to fix in order to get a better UX experience. Furthermore, for your customers, you can of course send them deals. This is basically offers. If they want a deal or an offer on a specific project, then you can create it here. And then you will have a pipeline where you can basically move the deal depending on your pipeline and where the deal is in the flow. The next module is their HR module, where you basically control and manage your colleagues, so to speak. In here, you will have a list of the different colleagues, what their role is within Agiled. You can make teams within your colleagues if you have a team for development, a team for marketing. Furthermore, you can work on designation, attendance, holiday, leaves, payroll, and teammate salary. So this means that you can manage the entire aspect of having employees, colleagues, you can run payroll in here, you can control the vacation they take, if they're on leaves, if they have sick days, and so on. So this is very, very great. The next step is their projects. So one thing to notice with all these modules is that they are very basic. And this is what's well known for these all-in-one business management tools, that you get a lot of modules. You can see out here, there's almost 15 modules out here. And that's awesome because you have everything collected. However, it's not so specific. A cool thing that, for instance, Heroku is doing is that they take different elements from different companies, which means that, for instance, let's say Agiled teamed up with other companies. Let's say they teamed up with a salary company. Then that salary company is only focused on making the best possible salary, and Agiled will basically just import that so you had it in here and you could use it. In this way, you would get so good modules in here. But of course, this is a start and it's difficult to integrate a lot of different modules. However, it is something they're working on in the future. But in here, we have a project management tool where we can make categories, we can get a Gantt chart, we can make templates if there is a project that we do often. We can export to Excel, and of course, we can create a new project to get started. So in here, it is quite extensive in the information we need to add. For each project, we can connect a client if that's what we want. We can set some different elements here, whether a manual time is allowed or it has to be logged by a timer. We can set a start date, a deadline, or we can choose not to set a deadline. We can make a summary, We can set a budget allocated for this project, and then of course we can start it. When we have the project ready, this is what you see. This is basically the project details view, where it reminds me a lot of the dashboard we just saw. However, we can't configure this the same way. That could be a nice feature to add. But we can get an overview here of the budget we entered, which we didn't, hours allocated, earnings, expenses, and so on. And then we can deep dive into what members are attached to Agiled project we created here, milestones, what tasks are under this project. We can get a Gantt chart, we can see the files, invoices, timesheet, burn down chart, discussion. So one thing that's cool about Agiled is that everything is connected. This project is connected to a client, and to the client, contacts are connected, which means that invoices connected to this project automatically is connected to the client. So this is a very cool thing that we have this streamlining. Now, if you go to the automation module, we can set up workflows and flows in general. So imagine you have to do a series of events, and you basically do that a lot of times during the week or the month, then you can make the entire workflow here. So let's say that every time we finish a project, we need to send the invoice to the client, we need to set the project as done, and we need to move the invoice to pending approval from client, for instance. Then we could basically set the different elements up here saying apply project, add the invoice, send email to assigned contacts, for instance, with the invoice. Or if we make a deal, we could set up that every time the deal is signed, send the contract to the client so we can finalize it. The flows is a bit more simple. We can add a flow with different types, whether it's onboarding or on-demand, what users should be connected to this flow, and then we can add different steps that every time a user is onboarded, they need to read and sign a contract, they need to maybe see some content, they need to download a file, add a form, stuff like that. So that's a flow for either onboarding a new employee or colleague, or on demand, if there's just some stuff you need, let's say that there is some new stuff that you want to share with everyone, then you can add this as a flow. In the finance tab here, you basically control all of your finances, where you have estimates, the invoices sent out, payments received, expenses, credit note, if you're running subscriptions, and then they're working on building in an accounting module. The accounting module is definitely going to add the last cherry on top of everything, so you can manage your entire financial situation within Agiled. That'll be very interesting to see. As mentioned, they also have a contract module, whereas we have different types of contracts that you can create. So in here, you can see that we have contract types. We have a client that we're going to attach this contract to, the amount that the contract is about, and so on. So this is basically the step after the deal. So when the deal is approved, then a contract is sent to the client in this case, where the client has to sign, and then we have the deal approved, the contract signed, and we can now start on the project. In here, we can send proposals to a client. It works more or less the same as the deals. This is just a bit more specific, where you can choose the client, what is the title of the proposal, how long is this proposal valid? And this is a very important point, because often you can send out an offer or a proposal, and then you don't hear from the client, but then 1 year after they will come back to you and say, hey, we want this now. But then due to inflation and you're becoming a better freelancer or a company, then your prices has hired, and this proposal should then not be valid. So this is a great way. It's also another way to create urgency around your proposal, saying to the client, hey, if you want this deal or this proposal, which I have made specifically for you, I need an answer by, in this case, 2nd of July. In here, in the timesheet area, we can basically manage all of the time trackings, whether it's my own or it's my colleagues, and we can then control that everyone is tracking their time correct. And then based on that, we can make timesheets. So let's say you have a part-time colleague or a freelancer that you're using, then we can make timesheets in here. Furthermore, if you're a development team or just a software team, or you have a support online, then this is a great thing for you, because this is an entire ticket system. So let's say that a client raises an issue for you. Well, then in here you can create a ticket where you describe everything, and then the team who has to take care of it, whether it's the website team, web development team, or something third, they will be able to see it in here. And then you can follow the process for the ticket, and as soon as it's done, you can get back to the client who raised this ticket and then tell them that it's fixed. Depending on what plan you're on Agiled, you have a storage amount, as you see down here. I have 100 gigabytes, but this means that in here you can just drop files. If there are files you want to share with everyone, let's say that there are some news, you can just share them in here, or there are some specific documents or videos you want to save, you can save them in here. Then they have the chat functionality where you can chat with your entire team in here. This chat is very basic. I would like to see that they maybe just integrate with Slack, because as far as I know, there's no better chat at the moment than Slack. But this is also back to the point where I would love to see a tool just integrating a lot of great tools to create an all-in-one business management tool where the modules are just the best they can possibly be. Furthermore, they have a scheduling module down here where we have appointments and events. So let's say that you want to have an event with your colleagues where you have to go out and drink beers or something on a Friday. You can make that in here. And then of course, for the different appointments, you can make appointment types depending on what it is. And this is similar for the projects, the clients, the HR, and so on. For each module, you need to create types first in order for the module to work the right way. Furthermore, down here, if you have some quick announcement you want to make to your team or to the members within Agiled, you can make it in here where you can quickly add a new announcement. And then you can say to whether it's to your clients or to your teammates, let's say that you are hiring your hourly rate. Well, then you can send out to your clients that, hey, I'm hiring my hourly rate. You need to be aware of XYZ. But one thing I noticed when I used the announcement module was that they changed the plus they usually have down here to move it up here. This is creating a bit of confusion because every time I go to a module now, I need to check two places of where I need to create something within the module. I would like them to align that because in the entire platform, it is so streamlined. The last two modules down here, except for reports, is the forms module. Here you can quickly create a form if that's what you like, and then you can embed it on your website or where you want this form to be embedded. This can be that you want to gather some leads or you want some information or you just want to make a contact form. Well, this is basically just drag and drop where you put in the different elements here. Let's say we want a header, a text area, a select box, and so on. But as you can see, it's very limited. I don't see the big value of this. I would more like to have this functionality within an email tool or a tool that I can track everything around the form. This is just very basic, and every time I pull over a field, it takes me down to the bottom of the page. The last element down here is items. In here, it's basically if you're selling something. It can be an ebook, it can be a course, it can be a physical thing. Again, this is very basic and I don't see the big need for this. Maybe some of using it, I didn't find a need for it and how I would be able to use it the best way. To sum everything up, you have a reports module down here where you can pull out reports on either how the tasks are going, a billing report, how income versus expenses are going, if you want to get an overview of your finances. If you want an attendance report of how your colleagues are meeting in and tracking the time and so on. So the reports module is basically wrapping up all of the different business modules here in order for you to get an overview of how it's going with your business and your company. So this is definitely a great thing. And especially because you have everything in Agiled, then using the reports module is just making it even more seamlessly. In the settings sections in here is basically where you set up everything. So if you want to use finances and you want to change your invoice to be a little bit more your style, you can change the colors, you can change the design of the invoice. The same you can do with the emails that's sent out from Agiled. You can control how they look in the different modules here. You can control the colors. Then they have integrations down here where you can integrate with HubSpot, SendFox, ActiveCampaign, Asana, and so on. And this you can use for the forms, for instance, or whatever you would like to use it for. So you can see all the settings here. I will not go into them. I will just show you briefly here in the menu. You can also set up a white label. You can make custom webhooks. You can set settings for your chat and so on. The last thing is, of course, they have a night mode where you can see Agiled in a night mode if that's what you want. So yeah, that's the different modules of Agiled. I've shown you briefly because it is a huge system and I will not deep dive into the different elements. It's just to show you. When we take a look at Agiled's pricing structure, it is very simple. Whereas the competitors is depending on the amount of members and the amount of users you add, then within Agiled, it's much more simple. You pay one price and then you get an amount of users that you can add to your plan. This is a huge bonus because often when it is that you add more members, it often gets a lot more expensive. But Agiled is actually a decent price with the amount of users that you get. Agiled has 4 different paid plans, whereas some modules differs, and of course you get more users you can add. They do also have a free plan if you want to get started and test out Agiled. This is a great way to just try it out and see if it's for you. The competitors to Agiled is definitely Hello Bonsai and Honeybook. And the thing that's common between all of these all-in-one business management tools is the design. They really know that their users spend a tremendous amount of time using their tools. So the design really needs to be user-friendly, and it needs to be nice to look at because you spend so many hours looking at it and just managing it and navigating around within the system. Taking a look into the future of Agiled, it seems very interesting. They're working on a browser extension, which makes it possible for you to track your time on these different projects. This is easy in terms of the invoicing. So if they can streamline everything that from they track their time, put it into projects, and then furthermore into invoices, people and their users can save so much time using this tool. Furthermore, they're working on integrations. Again, this will save time. If we can integrate to our economic system or other different systems that are relevant for this all-in-one business management tool. However, one thing is worrying me. If you take a look at Agile's roadmap, a lot of the different tools that they're building and the browser extension and the plugins and integrations have been in progress for almost half a year now. A lot of them have been in progress since mid last year, and it's a little bit worrying to see this as it is a huge tool, and I know it takes a lot of time to develop modules like this, but half a year for a tool, they're still a little bit in the beginning phase. It's a little bit worrying to see. I hope that they will catch up and start developing features and just shooting them out to the users again. So yeah, using Agiled, I have definitely saved a lot of time as I could do everything within Agiled. I could work, I could use my projects, I could manage the freelancers that I work with, and so much more. I had everything collected in there. And with the features coming up and the entire streamlining of the system, it's just going to be even better. So yeah, that's my review of Agiled, an all-in-one business management tool with an interesting future. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe. And if you have any questions about Agiled or other products you would like me to review, please leave a comment down below. Thank you so much for watching. Let's catch up on the next one.